Welcome back to Sad Games, and we're about to walk through a door in a prostitution brothel thing because...
Welcome to Sad Games. We have now walked through a door in a prostitution sad thing because...
It's a cubby.
Hey.
Oh, it's Lily's.
It's Lily's cubby.
It's empty.
The dead cubby. The cubby's as dead as her soul.
What the fuck is this shit? Oh.
Looks like some lipstick. Gloss, compact, and... Oh. They're glitter coins. Or tablets or whatever.
What's that? A note? What are notes? I like notes. Are they secrets? I like secrets.
Thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients.
So that now we have a connection between Lily and Faith.
Hmm.
Not only did they work at the same place, but at some point Lily substituted for Faith substituted for Lily at one of her for one of her clients. Which might have been when she died.
It's also busted open. Huh.
Broken open. But there isn't even a lock.
What?
Interesting.
How do you break open a box that doesn't have a lock?
Because you're impatient. Excuse me.
I heard you out there.
Yeah, I could tell.
I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
Maybe you're blind.
I didn't have a reason to come here before.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, don't look down on yourself. I'm sure you could get a good job. Maybe applying lipstick better.
You're trying to place me.
Have you tried being a grocery store clerk?
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Oh.
Once upon a time. Does that help?
That's why she's wearing the green dress and has the red hair with the flower.
What do they call you now?
She even did like a fish move on the pole. You see that?
Yeah.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
That's why I'm talking to you. You have those answers.
Does the number 207 mean anything to you?
Because it's literally my only lead and I really need help here.
Where?
Yeah.
Can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean can't.
I'm starting to think this is sort of a curse.
Discretion is our guarantee.
Holy shit, what are you, fucking brainwashed?
It's how things work here.
Three separate people have said the exact same words.
Yeah, like, I don't give a fucking damn about this shit.
I don't give a damn about your guarantee. I need you to cooperate. This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
Wow, I sound fucking paranoid.
These lips.
I seriously think there's some sort of like curse.
These lips are for dickin', suck dickin'?
Sheriff.
Dick sucking?
Would you like to make an appointment with me?
Yes. Wait, was that a trick question?
She's clearly hinting at something.
Okay.
Okay.
What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
Ah, oh, fuck.
Dun, dun, dun.
Okay.
Do I really?
Yeah, you still don't have any money on you. You've been broke since the first scene of this fucking series.
Wait here for a second.
Aw, I made a hooker pay for me. I feel good about myself.
I don't think that's usually what people mean when they say that.
Oh, is it not? Oh, am I supposed to feel bad because she paid out of her own pocket?
Which no, I mean, I don't think that's usually what they mean when they say, ah, I got a hooker to pay for me.
207.
Like, and they're boasting.
Oh.
You'll think of something.
Oh, I know what we're going to do. Arms.
So you don't have the right door, but you can get in at least. Stay. That's important.
I hope you find what you're looking for.
Wait, you're not going to be there?
Nope.
What the fuck?
She got you your in, though. She made up an appointment. I seriously think that she has some sort of freaking spell put over her and like everyone else in there where they just can't say anything. Though just because they always recite the exact same lines so specifically.
made them
cry. Like, I think this was her workaround, was to send you here so you could check it out yourself. Now this game has black characters.
It was a nice piece of ass. What you looking at?
Hand over the eyes, subtle. I'm just adjusting my hat, not guarding my face.
Yeah, I'm not coming out of a hotel room or anything.
That is a hotel with a gaping hole.
Oh, no, Keith, you went there. God, seriously, though.
That sign had all the innuendo.
It's also called open arms. Like, come on. You can't fucking make this shit any more risque.
Watch me.
Oh, God, please don't.
Just draw a sphincter over the O.
Ew.
We're about to learn something.
Can't smoke here?
No.
Oh, good.
There's no public restrooms.
Oh.
Smile, you're on camera. Lulz, keep smoking indoors, asshole.
What time do you guys close? Rooms or anything? Oh, fuck. Lobby.
They should cut their rates.
Oh, yeah? Who are you going to call?
The Ghostbusters?
Oh, I'm gonna call about
that.
Fucking
cat?
Yeah, I remember that. It was from the first episode.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
I forgot already.
Remember I was talking about fucking...
It has been 3 months.
Oh, that's true.
So I'm sure I forgot the cat poster.
Keep your pants on, buddy. You have to check in first if you want a room.
Oh, so you are here.
Ooh, I wonder who that is.
So come on. Mosey on back and we'll get you set up.
Why can't I go upstairs? What's going on up there?
Oh, hey, Beauty.
Oh,
Beauty.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent.
Okay.
So, now you know.
So she has the same voice actor as TJ.
I should have told somebody. But Beast would lose his mind if you knew.
Gee, I would really hate for him to find out.
He wants to do right by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted.
Doesn't he?
Beauty. I could honestly not care less about this. Do what you want.
All right, jeez. I thought since you didn't tell Beast you saw me, you cared how I felt.
Nope.
I guess not.
Don't give a fuck.
So, like, what are you doing here?
Zero fucks given. Let's move on. Help me find the murder, please.
Here.
Oh, you have a key.
I didn't just walk into this fucking hotel without a reason.
Murdered last night.
I heard.
Oh, yeah?
The victim was someone who worked at the pudding and pie.
God damn it.
It's a terrible name.
Yes. I don't want anybody's pudding in my pie.
Oh, yes.
That was not the other way around.
Oh, God.
I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Wasn't she a troll?
Yeah, that's probably why.
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamoured as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
Well, that was the wrong move, because now she's dead.
Oh, yeah.
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job?
I like how I have to put that in quotes.
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Someone named Mr. Smith.
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
Get it? More penis jokes. Millimeters.
Ever meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know.
Well, what the fuck do you know?
Blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather.
Oh,
sorry.
God. Must be tough.
She's incredibly useful.
I talked to Tweedledee earlier today. He mentioned you in passing. Do you know him?
Oh yeah, I totally forgot about that.
Took out a loan for back pay. It was like our third notice. And ever since then, those annoying freaks have been pestering me for the money plus interest.
Why take out a loan from those two?
It was from the crooked man.
Beauty.
You don't know how desperate I was, Bigby. I had nowhere else to go.
You could have got a job.
Turned to a soap opera world.
Yeah.
Come see me or Snow first, all right?
She doesn't seem to be following the part where you don't care about any of her shit.
That is fucking the worst thing you can do is just litter.
It'll be better if anyone.
He's really good at stomping out cigarettes in random people's buildings.
I didn't let you just wander around by
yourself. I have a fucking key.
We'll see.
Whoa.
She thinks she's going to get in trouble for you being in here.
Okay, never mind. That's why Beast was beating me up. He thought I was trying to sleep with his wife.
Yep. You just guessed what happens right now, basically.
Seriously, dude, I'm not going to fuck your wife. I have no interest in, like, some bitch who can't even follow a sign.
So do you no longer think he's the murderer?
No, it's not Beast. I thought, for some reason, I got it stuck, wrong in my head. I thought, because, like,
you think it was him laughing because laughing at Beast because of his Beast form thing?
Yeah.
And because everyone hated him?
Yeah.
I never heard that line, though, before.
It was, don't look at me, not don't laugh at me. Oh, yeah. That was my bad. It's
just, so how does it feel to be wrong about everything, Andrew?
It's, no,
Not lie, just not include my name.
It's someone I'm not aware of yet.
You'll do what you
don't
have
laugh
to.
At me. That's.
I just want you to know that that would help me. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
I was actually able to figure out who it was.
Really?
Yeah. Although I have an advantage because I was reading the Book of Fables.
Well, what the fuck? I mean.
Well, because the Book of Fables gives you background on the various characters, which is mostly just their fairy tale background, so you could potentially know it anyway, but that's how I keep track of this shit.
Sounds pretty interesting.
You could just go for 207.
I know, I just wanted to hear what was going on.
I'm like, guess which door it is. Could it be the one at the end of the hall?
Oh.
Spoilers, people are fucking.
Oh, man. Really?
Shocker, I know.
Well, sorry, I'm going to have to come in here. I said, sorry, I'm going to have to come in here.
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
A key?
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. Seriously, what?
I mean, I can break it down.
I could get into a lot of trouble.
Okay.
I could just break in the door if you prefer.
No, don't. I'll help you. Just don't. Break anything.
That's a good. That's
well, she gives in fast.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
This is a useful thing to have in people that are around you in this game. It's people that give in the moment you should put any
that's
pressure
weird.
On them.
This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty.
What could that mean?
Shit.
Beast.
Big B.
Uh oh.
How could you do this to me?
Are you fucking kidding me, dude?
No, sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you.
Whoa.
I love.
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me with him.
No.
No. No. Beast.
Can I talk? Cause I really want to clear my name. Like, please don't lump me with this ugly ass bitch.
Bet. I'm sure you help each
oh,
other.
Oh well,
just
this is not
great.
Going to die down at all. Look at his eyes.
Hey. Whoa.
Stop this right now.
This goes in one direction.
The way to handle things.
What do you know? You don't have anybody.
Oh, he's growing horns.
What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
I don't fucking want to have sex with her.
There's
dude, trust me.
I'm
yep.
Hey.
Time for quick time events. Good luck.
See you for who you are.
Stop! Stop it!
Is this you staying out of it? I thought I could trust
just
you.
Just fucking talk
listen
to her!
Listen to your wife. Just calm down and...
Beast!
Oh, there's the horns.
Dude.
I don't see this going downhill. Yep.
Like, dude, seriously.
Well, at least he's easy to dodge.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You
oh, claws are out.
To me.
Dude, bro, you fucked.
Stop.
She's my wife, Bigby.
Yeah, you mashed the button.
Yeah, well, you know
hard.
What?
Jesus.
Can I throw him into the door?
I like how the wall's paint broke off before he made contact.
Yeah, I noticed
that.
That was pretty interesting.
couple rendering
leave
problems.
Me.
Man, you wolfed out fast.
I'm fucking sexy ass wolf. Oh my god, dude, no, okay, well, I'm not taking it this far.
This is very rude.
Like, seriously, dude, just stop.
Do you have some emotional problems?
Oh god. Oh. Does he have emotional problems? He has some physical problems, I fucking tell you what.
How's blindness going for you? It's okay, Fables heal, remember? Just like that guy's arm. That guy's arm. All
right.
That guy's arm grew red back, remember?
Like, yeah.
I'm genuinely surprised Grendel's arm is still gone.
Oh, come on! God damn it.
Don't worry, this is almost over.
Why? Because
you ruined everything.
How can you see?
She's my fuck.
Get him.
Boom. Knock, knock. By the way, I hope no one was fucking.
Now you don't have to worry about how you open this door. Oh, there's the flowers. Remember the purple flowers?
What have you done?
In the body's hand.
What is this?
It's a murder scene?
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you...
Stand back! You don't want to see this.
Dun dun dun.
Wow, that is the most violent fucking period I've ever seen.
Shit.
That took a
what
turn.
What is it? Oh my god.
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
What? The worst fucking orgasm of anybody's life?
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
So that's...
Oh my god. Man, I don't want to deal with this right now. Just fucking tell me who rented the room.
Beast is so dumb.
Not last night. Maybe they have it long term. I don't know. How am I supposed to know?
You work here.
It doesn't seem like a totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
It was a troll.
Man, she's lapsing into Clementine voice so hard.
The hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
Can you see?
Just do what he says.
Can you see what I'm saying? Because okay. Your eyes look a little fucked up right now, bro.
Seriously, you need to see a doctor, man.
Yeah.
Also, push those horns back in. Do some fooly-cooly shit.
What kind of a person could do something like this?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Exactly what I'm about to try.
You guys are back in sync.
Oh my god.
Another creepy cassette.
I can't believe this.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with the built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes.
Well, that's pretty fucking fancy.
Yeah. Just continue to date the when this game's supposed to take place.
Where'd you get that?
Lily had it in her hand. There was any doubt over who died here.
What's that? Storybook, huh?
So that certainly places the body. Oh, hey, Snow White.
What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the mundiverse of the story.
Mit blauen Augen und... I can't read that. It's the font is so hard.
Yeah.
Mir auch recht und Worte...
Was she breathing?
Why is she in a glass coffin?
Oh.
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they
so that's what the bed
dead.
Was modeled after.
Oh.
The fet with all the flowers.
Right.
Yeah, it's getting
What's
dark.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
I would totally try to read all that German, like,
made
to understand it if it was fucking
picture.
Spelled right.
Flowers too. He'd have had Lily.
You have connected
down,
the evidence.
Like
thanks.
You mean just before?
We're learning
story,
more things here.
That's when someone comes to kiss her.
So they also have an obsession with Snow White, and also they speak German.
The weird fixation on snow. What the hell is wrong with this guy?
Wait, don't laugh at me.
It probably means that whoever it is, they're probably a German fable.
But Snow White related?
Well, the being obsessed with Snow White doesn't have to be part of the Snow White fable. That could be part of the storyline of the actual of just this.
You were the only one who smoked
someone else who smokes the same cigarette as you.
Apparently not.
What?
Dun dun dun.
Wait, I feel like I'm missing something here.
Classy.
Classy wine?
Poor girl.
Huh, I wonder who we know who likes wine. There's a disgusting amount of clues.
Wait. The Huntsman?
Oh, cassette. Who's the Huntsman?
Or the Woodsman?
Oh, okay. I'm like, Huntsman's not even a character.
Sorry.
He just made that one up.
The Woodsman?
We're hearing music right now.
The only person I think that really loves wine is the
Vicky,
fucking
this,
monkey.
I think I heard
Buffkin's the one behind it all along.
Damn it!
That'd be hilarious.
Stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here.
I thought that was you farting.
Would have covered up the sound of the murder.
But I can never
cover. So they're blaring music to hide the sound of the murder.
That's pretty smart.
and they cut off people's heads.
So wait, they smoke the same cigarettes as me. They also like wine.
They like wine. They're obsessed with Snow White. They know a lot of details about Snow White, and then chop people's heads off.
Yeah, it sounds like the woodsman.
Check the apple behind you. Oh, the closet too, actually. That's a little piece of thing. Creepy.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no. She must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back.
Stop. You're terrible at this.
No, there's no blood.
Yeah, she's really bad at this.
It must have been torn.
Can you leave the room?
Yeah. Can I ask you to leave the room because
all of your suggestions are wrong.
What are you thinking?
He could be a cross-dresser. What a great choice if you're an idiot.
God.
I think Smith was.
I know I connected the evidence. I'm not fucking dumb. Like,
I love how they give you options that are just like, are you an idiot?
It's the same dress. It fits. He's acting out scenes from the book.
This is really sick.
The only one I can think of is like the dwarf.
She probably just needed the money.
She oh no.
Could have been anyone.
It's one of the dwarves, is it?
How did she wind up here?
God, please don't tell me it's one of the dwarves. Exactly.
It wouldn't be much of a mystery if the culprit was not an established character.
Sounds like there was a series of choices involved. I'm sure she'd have done things differently if she knew where things were.
I wasn't even reading. I don't know what we were talking about.
Well, there's an apple at the foot of the bed to your left.
So scared.
It took me a while to find it, so I'm just going to tell you it's there. There it is.
Wait.
Do you smell something?
Ichabod?
No. Just apple.
It's an apple.
No, there's more? What? What now?
The extent to which they recreate the scenes is fucking creepy.
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh, no. Do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course. That makes perfect sense.
Wait, the prince that killed himself?
This person's got some emotional
acting
problems.
Out another part of the book.
It couldn't be the prince because he died before Lily died.
This creep put that girl in a Snow White dress and recreated the whole story
but
from the book.
But who would be annoyed
at
someone laughing at them
the
aside from like
everything? You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
Thanks? Yeah, what a fucking bitch.
It's a weird detail to point
out.
Yeah,
like I'm thinking of all the characters that exist, like
when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up.
The woodsman?
I hope you're just about
Ichabod.
Through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer.
The fucking trolls. You.
What, do you think the trolls did it?
No.
It'd be weird if she killed her own sister.
Yeah.
What's in the envelope? What's in the box?
Seriously not Ichabod, though, is it? Like, that'd be weird as fuck. Oh, this is not weird as fuck either. Like,
pictures of the dead girl.
Snow.
No, these are pictures of Snow White.
How do you know?
I'm in this one.
Oh, someone's known you for a while.
Oh no, Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer.
Oh no, it is Ichabod.
His stand-in
oh, no.
is gone now, so.
Oh no.
Step closer.
Oh god damn
dun,
it.
Dun dun.
What is it?
It's Crane.
There you go. Oh, and he knows you know.
God damn it.
Suck it, mirror. No more rhyming for now.
Okay, breaking a mirror isn't really going to do much because now I know. So unless, unfucking believably less.
No, he smashed the mirror so you can't use it to track him.
So what does he think? I'm just a person? Motherfucker, I could smell you and your antacids. You got gas for days.
No respect for the dead. Next time on Wolf Among
oh,
Us.
Oh, fuck!
Yeah.
God damn
That's
it.
The end. I tried to keep a straight face so hard when you said Ichabod. Also, when you said, when you were so sure it was Beast, I'm like, yeah, okay.
It could
yeah.
be after you now.
Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
No. Please don't. Because he wants to get his hands up your skirt.
I was going
to
say, like, he wants his hands on you. probably gonna put that on you. Oh shit, that's a problem. So Ichabod's on the run and he has a glamour, so he's gonna disguise himself as someone else.
Unless he can disguise his smell.
He's dying to like you, Sheriff.
What if he impersonates you? Complete
bastard.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Hey, Lee.
Wait, what?
I mean, Bluebeard.
Wait, whoa, whoa, wait, what? Why is Bluebeard? What?
Hello, Bigby.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
This fucking next episode looks like so much drums.
So much drums.
Jesus Christ.
I feel like they're gonna hint at
Holy shit.
They hinted at that last time too, though.
What?
Last time it was a silhouette, but they showed you all wolfed out as a silhouette. I think they're just gonna keep hinting at the fact that, oh my god.
Whoa.
Wow, you are in the vast minority right there. Wow. You made minority decisions all episode, didn't you? Let's scroll down. Oh, yeah, everyone lets Snow come with them.
How did you treat the murder suspect?
You beat the fuck out of him.
How did you handle? Yep. Okay. Wow. A lot of people didn't do that.
Hit Georgie?
28%.
Yeah.
Wow.
No, I didn't hit him.
How do you not? He's a fucking piece of shit.
I just kept walking around with the mallet taunting him with next to all of his valuable things.
Did you keep punching Beast when he was down?
What? Oh. Only 31% of people opt not to hit Beast.
Wow.
Wow. I'm shocked by that. Like, yeah. 70% of people just keep hitting him. I didn't hit him.
What
again.
A bunch of fucking ass. Like, I'm an asshole, but I'm not that much of an asshole.
I'm gonna have us bring up some fable entries that'll help explain a few things that have happened.
Bluebeard managed to escape the homelands with his riches intact and continues to be one of the wealthiest fables in New York. The Fabletown government depends on his generous contributions, and he often uses his influence for his own benefit. As a former serial killer, he claims his days of decapitating his brides are over, but even if he was able to leave his violent ways in the homelands, that hasn't stopped him from making the occasional trip down Crooked Lane.
So that explains a bit of why he's potentially taking over in the next episode, is because he's one of the most influential people in this society.
Yeah, he's also
so
going to be
he,
one of
so
the most,
he
like...
he has some potentially illegitimate but still strong power, basically.
Oh, so...
They also use him as a red herring because his fable is about decapitating people who are women. Yeah. So I think that's actually why... I didn't realize this at the time because I didn't know who Bluebeard was before we started this.
Yeah.
But I think that's why a weirdly large number of people in episode one vote is that he's the suspect, even though he's literally not even established as a character at that point.
Oh.
Because you can vote for him, and people do, yeah. Like way more than anyone I voted for.
Well,
then we'll go to...
wait, what?
Let's, go to, let's go to Crane. Because you didn't get them. You have to make specific decisions to unlock some of them.
Oh.
Let's go to Crane.
Wow, I almost have all of them.
Yeah, you get there's only one in episode one and one in episode two that you have to play a second time to get.
Oh.
So let's click on the crane right here.
Oh god, this is going to be so obvious, isn't it? Oh god.
Yeah, this will explain the don't laugh at me.
During his days in Sleepy Hollow, Ichabod Crane fell in love with a wealthy young woman named Katrina Van Tressel. She was beautiful and very rich, but that meant she was also caught the attention of another suitor. Abraham Brom Van Brunt. As Ichabod's rival, Brom would plan nasty pranks in order to humiliate the often superstitious school teacher. Despite Brom's plots to win Katrina over, Ichabod believed he would be chosen as her favorite. After a party at her father's home, Ichabod proposed to Katrina and he was very quickly rejected. He immediately rode off in shame and was never seen in Sleepy Hollow again. According to Crane, he was chased out of town by the Headless Horseman, but in reality, it was probably just another one of Brom's pranks.
So because of that entry, the combination of women being decapitated, the weird obsession with a different woman, and like the don't laugh at me, I just was like, oh, it's Ichabod.
I got none of that from this. Like, I got none of that from this. That is pretty amazing.
The part
that
where he's chased
at
what? The part where he's like, he's constantly being pranked and being humiliated. So when he was trying to win the love of someone, but instead he was basically laughed away and constantly humiliated.
And I guess.
Then he's decapitating women and saying, "Don't laugh at me." When like he's from the Headless Horseman story, and he was literally like laughed away when he tried to. Proposed to someone.
But see, I wouldn't know that unless I read the entry.
Which yeah, that's the thing. Is that's the I read the entries as they show up, and that's what gave away super fast what the ending was for me.
I don't know. I feel like that's kind of boring. I don't know.
I don't think you're necessarily supposed to figure it out in advance. It's just a murder mystery, and it's like, oh wow, and like the reveal happens.
But the fucking elevator gets a goddamn journal entry.
It's about the 13th floor.
Oh,
it's just an entry about the witches.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's all that's really super relevant. Most of them are just backgrounds to individual characters. We'll see what happens next.
Can't wait. See you in 3 months.
Probably be like 3 more months. Yeah. If Telltale keeps fucking up their release schedule.